Hello all, welcome. Today we discuss types of windows. People's task must be structured into a series of windows. The type of window used will depend on the nature and flow of the task. Defining standard window types is again difficult across platforms because of the varying terminologies and definitions used by different windowing systems and changes in terminology for new versions of systems. For simplicity, the Microsoft Windows windowing scheme will be described now. Summarized are a description of the window, its purpose, and its proper usage. Any other platform's windows may not behave exactly as presented, and some platform windows may exhibit characteristics common to more than one of the described window types. Okay, now let's discuss the primary window. The proper usages of primary window should represent an independent function or application used to present constantly used window components and controls. Menu bar items that are used frequently, used by most or all primary or secondary windows. Controls used by dependent windows, used for presenting information that is continually updated, for example, date and time. Used for providing context for dependent windows to be created. The primary window should not be used to divide an independent function into two or more primary windows. Present unrelated functions in one primary window. It should not be done. This is the example of a primary window, the Microsoft Windows primary windows. Here we see all the drives in the my computer. Okay. But my primary window is the first one that appears on a screen when an activity or action is started. It is required for every function or application processing a menu bar and some basic action controls. As previously described, it should present the framework for the functions, commands, and data and provide top level context for dependent windows. It has also been variously referred to as application window or the main window. In addition, it may be referred to as the parent window if one or more child windows exist. Microsoft Windows primary window is shown in the figure. Okay. The primary window is a main focal point of the user's activities and should represent an independent function. Avoid dividing an independent function to two or more primary windows and avoid presenting unrelated functions in a single primary window. This tends to confuse people. Independent function should begin in a primary window. A primary window should contain constantly used window components such as frequently used menu bar items and controls, for example, control bars used by dependent windows. Also include primary window continually updated information such as date and time. There is one more type of window, secondary window. The proper usage is for performing subordinate, supplemental, or ancillary actions that are extended or more complex in nature related to objects in the primary window. For presenting frequently or occasionally used window components, we use secondary windows. There are some important guidelines. Should typically not appear as an entry on the taskbar. A secondary window should not be larger than 263 dialog units. Okay, into 263 dialog units. The dimension. This is the best example of a secondary window. Okay, just look at it. There is a tap, stop position, default stop position, and etc. Secondary windows are supplemental windows. Secondary windows may be dependent upon a primary window or displayed independently of the primary window. They structurally resemble a primary window, possessing some of the same action controls and possibly what's this button? Okay, the question mark. A dependent secondary window is one common type. It can only be displayed from a command on the interface of its primary window. It is typically associated with a single data object and appears on top of the active window when requested. It is mobile and scrollable. If necessary, it uses the primary window's menu bar. Most systems permit the use of multiple secondary windows to complete a task. In general, dependent secondary windows are closed when the primary window closes and hidden when their primary window is hidden or minimized. An independent secondary window can be opened independently of a primary window. For example, a property sheet displayed when the user clicks the properties command on the menu of a desktop icon. An independent secondary window can typically be closed without regard to the state of any primary window unless there is an obvious relationship to the primary window. Proper usage of a secondary window. Although secondary windows share many characteristics with primary windows, they also differ from primary windows in behavior and use. Secondary windows are used to perform supplemental or subordinate tasks or tasks that are extended in nature. Frequently and occasionally, used window components should also be presented in secondary windows. Microsoft Windows possesses several types of secondary windows called dialog boxes, property sheets, property inspectors, message boxes, palette windows, and pop-up windows. There are some guidelines. A secondary window should typically not appear as an entry on the taskbar. Secondary windows obtain or display supplemental information that is usually related to the objects that appear in the primary window. The model and modeless, let's discuss. Model, which appears as a pop-up dialog in web applications, used when interaction with any other window must not be permitted. It can be used for presenting information, for example, messages, okay? Sometimes called message box, dialog box also. Receiving user input, yeah. Models can be used to receive user input, for example, data or information, sometimes called prompt box. There might be a checkbox. User is allowed to select that checkbox. In such scenario, we use model. Asking questions also, for example, data or information, directions, sometimes called question box also. Use carefully because it constrains what the user can do. There is some sort of validation things also. Modeless, use when interaction with other windows must be permitted. Use when interaction with other windows must be repeated. Secondary window can be modal or modeless. Modal, most secondary windows will be modal. Modal windows will not permit interaction with another window until the current dialog is completed. It remains displayed until the appropriate action is taken, after which it is removed from the screen. Modal dialog boxes typically request critical information or actions that must be reacted to before the dialog can continue. Since modal dialog boxes constrain what the user can do, limit their use to situation in which additional information is required to complete a command, or when it is important to prevent any further interaction until satisfying a condition. Modeless, a modeless dialog box permits the user to engage in parallel dialogue, switching between the box and its associated window is permitted. Other tasks may be performed while a modeless dialog box is displayed, and it may be left on the screen after a response has been made to it. Actions leading to a modeless dialog box can be cancelled, causing the box to be removed from the screen. Use modeless dialog box when interaction with a primary window or another secondary window must be permitted, for example, during the accessing of the help function. Also, use modeless dialog box when interaction with other windows must be repeated, for example, in word search operation. Thank you for watching. We continue this types of windows in the next part.